Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn a new poem, A Tiger in the Zoo. A Tiger in the Zoo. The name of the author is, or the poem is, Leslie Norris. Leslie Norris. Okay? L-E-S-L-I-E-N-O-R-R-I-S. Leslie Norris. Okay? Let's know about the points what we are going to know from this poem. One is, before you read about the poet. Point two, reading of the poem. Point three, word notes, that is vocabulary and paraphrasing of poem, that is summarizing of the poem. Comprehension check, discussion on question and answers, and if any found writing skills or language device, that will be covered in this poem. So let's have a lesson number, a poem number three, that is A Tiger in the Zoo. So let's know about it and we'll start about the poem. It's a Leslie Norris, was a famous Welsh poet. W-E-L-S-H, Welsh poet and short story writer. He was born in 1921 in Wales. So he was born in Wales, W-A-L-E-S, place. Leslie Norris had decided even at an early age that he would become a poet. So in the very early age only he thought and made his decision to become a poet. He was very much interested in the poems of Glan Thomas and Vernon Watkins. Okay, the other poets who were there, he was impressed by their writings. One is Glan Thomas and Vernon Watkins. Okay, his first poem was published in year 1938, but his first book of poetry came out in 1943. So, first poem published in 1938 and his first book on poems came in year 1943 to be published. In July 1942, Norris married Catherine, better known as Kitty. So her nickname or with a love, she was called as Kitty. They moved to England and trained themselves to be teachers. Later on, they moved towards England and they were called trained teachers. He shot to fame with his first publication. So he was shot to be famed, popular. His first publication, what is that? Finding Gold, his first book. His works won various awards, including the Cholmondeley Poetry. So, there are a number of works he has wrote, and there is one poetry book named Cholmondeley Poetry Prize, and the Catherine Mansfield Memorial Award. So, he also got some prizes and awards in his writings. Leslie died in 2006, and in 2006 Leslie passed away. Let us know the central idea of the poem A Tiger in the Zoo. The tiger is proud creature, okay, is a well-known proud creature of it because of its strength. It is a shame that such a powerful, agile and untamable animal should be caged in a zoo. So it looks like a shame, such a powerful animal and all, and cannot be controlled or seeing that anyone who goes to show his power, he will fail in that. Such kind of a powerful animal with enormous strength is found shameless. Why? Shameful. Why? Because it is kept in the cage or in a zoo. In his natural and wild habitat, he doesn't need help of any kind to hunt his own food. So, in his natural and wild habitat, where wild animals are there, doesn't need help of any kind. So, he doesn't require any kind of a help to hunt its own food. It can kill, catch any big animal or a creature, fight and kill them and can eat. Even human beings. Remember, his hunting of deer at the water hole may seem rather cruel. So, when the water, where the water place is there, where the deer will come to drink water, or especially the baby deers. There you can see the cruelty of this animal. Okay? He will jump or leap on the deers when they come to drink water and will kill and eat. He hunts not for pleasure but for food. So there is no any kind of a pleasure in winning or showing victory but for his own food. His presence in the natural habitat is necessary to maintain the balance of food chain. So he is very much important in the natural habitat instead of keeping in the zoo. to maintain the balance, the environmental balance or the ecological balance. Sometimes the tigers may stray into human habitation. Sometimes they may come in a human habitation because we are doing deforestation, cutting off trees. So where will they go? They will come to our house and we will be the ready-made food for them. Then he only displays his strength and ferociousness. So he shows his strength and makes fearful for others. But he doesn't harm anyone till he is provoked. It will not harm to anyone unless and until you provoke, unless and until you harm to it by throwing stone or trying to make a fun of it or something else. When you do, then only it tries to show its anger and power. Even in the cage, he ignores all those who come to the zoo. So in the cage also you can see, it will ignore to all those who come over there. And in the zoo, to see him as an entertainment, and people come to see him as an entertainment. Okay, for people it is something new, but for him it feels like insulting. Okay, because he is kept in the zoo and he doesn't want to stay in the zoo. He shows his anger, hatred and even defiance by walking about in rain in his cage. So he also showers his anger inside the cage, hatredness and as well as defiance, also tries to defend by walking inside the cage. Okay, he wants, like human beings, the tigers love to freedom. They also love for our freedom. They want to walk openly in the forest and all. Human progress should not be at the cost of destroying the natural habitats. So if we want to make a progress, we should not make a loss of natural habitats, of untamable, and that too untamable, unable to tame or domesticate. And proud animals like the tiger, especially the proud animals like tiger, which are courageous, strength and all, keeping them in the zoo and again giving them the quantity of food and doing all these vestiges and all. Okay, and even there is no imbalance, it is imbalance in the ecological and environment. So it won't look good. Let's know about the style of the poem and the language of the poem. The poem consists of 5 stanzas. Each is made up of 4 lines. So it is made up of 4 lines every stanza. The rhyme scheme is ABCB, 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 all the 5 stanzas. The poem has 2 distinct settings. Different settings are there. The first setting is that of the zoo, where the tiger is put in a cage. So one side it will tell about the tiger in the cage. Okay, and the second setting is that of the natural wild habitat of the tiger. And second one is the forest, natural wild habitat of the tiger. It should have been his real place, and that is his real place, which should have been his real place in sense. The tiger's natural place is forest only and natural habitat. The personification of the tiger is evident as the poet calls him he. So now animal is given respect saying he. So that is a personification. Okay, personally it has been connected to the tiger. And not tone represents the, and not it, and not it. So animal is not said it here, but it is given a respect and said he, the tiger. A metaphor, pads of velvet, is used effectively in the third line of the first stanza. Pads of velvet. Okay. The tense tone represents the hidden rage of the tiger. So the tense also tells about the tone, represents hidden rage of the tiger, hidden anger. Rage means showering of anger in the zoo. Let's know about the poem. Okay. He stalks in his vivid strips, the few steps of his cage. Okay, he is walking. Okay, vivid, very bright strips on the body. Stalk means to walk inside with anger, but inside the zoo in a limited manner. On pads of velvet white, pads cushion, velvet, a soft silk cloak. How is the body of a soft, like a velvet, pads. Even the pads which are made of what? Of a soft silk cloth. But it is not like that. It is his skin. It's a soft, silky hair on the body, yellowish color and brownish color. And you find him like as if it is pads of velvet white. That says about the metaphor, the body appearance. In his quiet rage, means in his calm anger. Calm anger, silently anger showering from the eyes and from his roaring sound. Okay, that shows inside the case because he is helpless. He is a helpless. So these are the things. Let us know about the paragraph number one's meanings. Stop means to walk angrily. Second, vivid means very bright. Velvet, a soft silk cloth, strips long lines on the body. Cage, a box made of bars or wire. Then rage, violent anger. Okay, violently showing anger inside the zoo. Then coming to question answers of paragraph number one. What can be said about the strips on his body? The strips on his body are clearly visible, the lines which are being found on the body. What are pads of velvet? The heels of the tiger are soft like the pads of velvet. Heels, panja, kalu, are being found like the pads of velvet. Where is the tiger now? The tiger is bound in his cage, is limited in his cage, inside the cage. Why is he in his quiet rage? He is unhappy and angry but controls his rage quietly. He is controlling his anger quietly but he is inside the cage. Paragraph number 2. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass. Sliding through long grass. So what he is doing? He must be waiting secretly. Waiting secretly under a tree. Now this is in the forest, not in the zoo. Okay, idu forest nalli, not in the zoo. Sliding through long grass. Now what is sliding here? Moving smoothly and quietly without making sound. Kauruvaagi nadithada. Near the water hole where clump deer passes. And where is going? Is going near the water place where the clump deer comes. Clump deer, baby deer. And he is going to attack on the baby deer and eat it. Idu ellidu? Idu forest nalli. Occasionally illa. So let us know, lurking, waiting secretly, okay, waiting secretly, hidingly, shadow, darkness, sliding through, moving slowly, avruvagi nadiyodu, talpo ayen agbardu, dhwani athwa, you know, gurta agbardu. Then water hole, a small pool of water, a place where water is stored or a small pool, where animals go to drink. A fat deer or a baby deer. Okay. Then question answers of paragraph number 2. Why does the tiger lurk in shadow? Answer. The tiger knows how to ambush his hunt and so he lurks in shadow unseen. He is hiding himself because he wants to catch the plump deer, the fat deer, or it may be called as a baby deer. Why does he slide through the long grass? So why is he walking slowly without making sound? Answer. He slides through the long grass to ambush his prey unseen and unnoticed. So to get his foot without making to know anyone and hidingly slowly moving from the grass. Okay. To catch the deer or any other creature who comes to drink water. Where does the tiger generally go in the search of his prey? The tiger generally goes to the water hole in the search of his victims. So it is going near to the water pond where animals come to drink water to catch the deer or animal. What can he find near the water hole? He can hunt his favorite plump deer who comes there for drinking water. So he can hunt the plump deer, the fat deer or maybe a deer which comes to drink water and can eat it. So this is all about the paragraph number 2. Let's see the paragraph number 3. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. At the jungle's edge. Again, this is also in the forest. This is also in the forest. So what do you see? He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. Snarling, making an aggressive growl or showing the teeth so that he wants to kill the animal and eat the animal. So what we can see is that here another is at the jungle's edge, at the border of the forest, at the edge of the forest. Okay. Then bearing his white fawns, white fangs, his claws. So what is bearing? Not covered with white fangs, two long sharp teeth. So bearing his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. Now how is he going to make scared for the people? By showing his teeth. Okay, by showing his teeth and also the big nails, claws, which can be used to pull and kill the body of the animal or a human being and to pull the flesh. Then claws, nail of animals or birds, terrorizing, creating fear. And this is how he is going to terrorize the village, by making sound and the whole village gets scared and afraid. Okay, this is what he says. He should be snailing around houses, all the jungle's edge and on the borders of the forest. He is making the people to get afraid, where the small huts are there and the village people are staying. Or the, what you can say, ಕಾಡ ಜನರು ಇರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಭಯ ತೋರಿಸೋದು. ಓಕೆ, ಬೋರಿಂಗ್, ಬೇರಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಂಗ್, ಸೊ ಹೀಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ವೈಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಪಂಜಾ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಗ್ ನೈಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಸೌಂಡ್, ರೋರಿಂಗ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೆರರೈಸಿಂಗ್, ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಮ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ನೇರ್ಲಿಂಗ್, ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ ಅಗ್ರೆಸಿವ್ ಗ್ರೌಲ್ ಆರ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟೀತ್ಸ್, ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಟೀತ್ಸ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್, ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. At the jungle stage, at the border of the jungle or on the border of jungle or forest, bearing, not covered with, okay, with white fangs, two long sharp teeth. So big sharp teeth he will show, big one, opening the mouth. And claws, nails of animals, and that is the claws which shows the big nails of animals, terrorizing, creating fear in the village or in the border of the forest. Okay, let's come to the question answers of para number 3. Where should be the tiger snailing around? He should be snailing around the houses of the human settlement, where the people are staying, the village people or the forest people. Where are the houses situated? The houses are situated at the edge of the jungle, at the border of the jungle. How does he terrorize the villagers? He terrorizes the villagers by opening out his long sharp teeth and powerful claws. Does he really attack the villagers? No, he doesn't really attack, but only terrorize the villagers. He don't attack, but he makes them to fear. Paragraph number 4. He is locked in a concrete cell. His strength behind bars. Now this comes in the zoo. Elite daronge inside the zoo. Concrete cell means made of cement and bar. Okay, that is rocks. His strength behind bar is of no use. He cannot break that cell, which is man-made. And stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. And he is keeping on walking inside the cage with a roaring sound. And avoiding the visitors because he feels shameless. Why? He has been kept in the zoo. And people come for the entertainment. They see, they throw some eatables, etc. and all. Children laugh on it, etc. Okay, locked, kept in the lock or put under a lock. Concrete cell, a cell made of a cement concrete with the irons. Strength, power, behind, backwards. Bars, prison. Ignoring, paying no attention. And visitors, person who visit to see. These are the meanings of the paragraph number 4. Where is the tiger locked now? The tiger is locked in a cage made up of cement and concrete. Then, what has gone wrong with his strength? The powerful tiger has put behind the bars. Such a powerful tiger is kept behind the bar and it cannot use its power. Where does he stalk around? He stalks proudly around the length of his cage. He hates to entertain the visitors and stalks proudly, just ignoring them. So why does he ignore? Because he feels shy. Even he feels insulting or shame, because people come and visit him, they throw some edible, children keep laughing, clapping, and that makes him what? You know, avoiding the visitors. Paragraph number 5, that is the last para of this poem. He hears the last noise at night, the patrolling cars. Now this is about again inside the zone. So what is hearing? The voice at night. And what is the voice? Voice of vehicles. The patrolling cars, the cars are there which are taking the rounds, for security. Okay. And stares with his brilliant eyes, and he sees with his open eyes brilliantly. And the brilliant eyes, what it then says, at the brilliant stars, and he's seeing the brilliant stars in the night, but he's inside the zoo. Inside the zoo. Forest nalli illa, zoo nalli idane. Okay. So what is the last voice night? The last voice heard at night. Koneya sappala ratriyalli kelodu. Okay. Patrolling cars, watching or keeping watch with the help of cars. Cars keep taking ground in the zoo. Then stares, looks for a long time, seeing for a long time. Then brilliant eyes, very bright eyes, very sharp eyes. Okay. Question number one of the para last. Where is the tiger locked in? The tiger is locked in a cage at a zoo or in a zoo. What does he hear at night? He hears the voice of the patrolling cars at night. Patrolling means they keep taking round with the torch and making horn. Why does he stare at the brilliant stars? He stares at the brilliant stars because they are shining freely in the sky. Oh, the twinkling stars are free in the sky and he is staring towards them. Why do cars patrol at night? The cars patrol at night to supervise and safeguard the animals lodged in the zoo. They want to see any animal is trying to break the cage or prison and trying to skip from the zoo, and it will be danger for other people also there and creatures. So that has to be seen by them carefully. So the cars are what they are doing. They are patrolling in the night. Okay. So this is all about the tiger in the zoo. Okay. So there is one of the writing skill also. Okay. Now what is the writing skill? It says, take a point of view for or against zoos. Zoo bagge bariri athwa viruddha bariri zoo bagge. Or even consider both points of view. Or hage eradu point bekadare neevu distinguish maadi baribodu. Write a couple of paragraphs. Write couple of paragraphs. Eradu mooru paragraphs bariri. Or speak about this topic for a couple of minutes in class. Illa andre class nalli ellar munde enu maadi ondu 3 nimisha aa vishaya mele maatadi. Okay, so this is about. Let's see the topic. Zoos don't preserve. Zoos don't preserve. Okay, or conserve animals. Keep safe animals, protect animals, but do not keep them in the zoos. Keep the forest as it is natural. Do not deforest. Respected president, teachers and friends, this is speech how you are going to write. They say zoos are very necessary. Zoo bahala avashyakte. Then how? I ask. So this is how I ask you. They say zoos are necessary for the protection and conservation of some species of animals. You can conserve animals, you can save them, you can keep protecting them inside the zoo and give them food and all. They can live in the zoo. Sir, I refute it totally. So I am against it totally. They should be given freedom. Avargu swatantrate kodabeku. Then let me tell my opponents that zoos are not the natural habitats of wild animals. Naan nimge helta idani, zoo is not a natural habitat. Avarge bandi madabardu. Let them be open free in the forest only. Do not make them to keep in the zoo. And can the king of the forest, the lion, live happily in a zoo? My question is, now he is the king of the forest, that is lion. But if you keep in the zoo, is it going to be happy? No. Can a ferocious tiger be happy behind the bars? Can a wild tiger be happy behind the bar or in the prison? No. I would say big no. So I would say a big no. I am not happy with this way of looking and taking care of animals. This is not the way of conserving animals or conservation of animals. Give him the food of his choice and take away his freedom. So you want to give him his food, but you want to take his freedom. By giving him food from the cage and keeping him in the cage is not going to help. The tiger will never bargain for it. So the tigers will never bargain for this food and that food. It will attack on any creature, any animal, and it will take the flesh, which is a fresh one, and eats according to its choice and interest. The tiger, sir, in the zoos, the wild animals like lions and tigers are merely showpieces. So you can see animals kept in the zoo, they look like a showpiece. ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಶೋ ಪೀಸ್ ಇರ್ತೀವಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಶೋ ಕೇಸ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ದೇ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ದರ್ ಓನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಬೈ ಟಿಕೆಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎಂಟರ್ಟೈನ್ ದಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ದೇ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ದ ಟಿಕೆಟ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಕೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಝೂ ಸೊ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟು ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರತೆ ಬರೀ ಮಾನವ ಅಧಿಕಾರ ಇಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳಿಗೂ ಹಾಗೂ ಬೇರೆ ಪಕ್ಷಿಗಳು ಕೀಟಾಣುಗಳಿಗೂ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರತೆ ಇದೆ ಸೊ ಅವ್ರ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರತೆ ನಾವು ತಗೋಬಾರದು And animals too need freedom to roam around freely in their natural habitat. They also expect to walk, wander here and there. ನಮಗೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಊರಲ್ಲಿ ತಿರುಗಬೇಕು ಆಟ ಆಡಬೇಕು ಸೊ ದೇ ಟು ಫೀಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಲಿವ್ ವಿತ್ ದೇರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಕಿಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಓಕೆ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಜಂಗಲ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೈಲ್ಡ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ವೈ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಜಂಗಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ವೈಲ್ಡ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಲಿವ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಹೋಮ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟಿವ್ ಟು ದ ಝೂ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟಿವ್ ಟು ದ ಝೂ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ A tiger reserve can serve all the necessary purposes. You can make a tiger reserve also. That can serve all the necessary purposes of the animals also and can maintain ecological balance for the survival of human beings and living beings. You can protect and preserve wild animals in the natural habitat. So this can be protected and preserved wild animals in the natural habitat. So let us leave them freely to live in the jungles and forests or making by big reserves for the special tigers and lions. So this can be helpful. So keeping in zoo is not a, what you can say, beneficial for all. So we should not take the freedom of anyone. This is what about the writing skill says. And this is all about your today's poem, A Tiger in the Zoo. I hope you understood the poem. Okay, we have also gone through the question answers and we have also gone through the word meanings. And one point is remaining is, let's see, that is your paraphrasing. A, B, C, B, A, B, C, B. That is of a rhyming scheme. Strips, cage, quite, red. Okay? Strips, cage, quite, red. Okay? Same sound. A, B, C, B. Then para number two, shadow, hole, grass, pass. Shadow, hole, grass, pass. Next para number three, houses, clause, edge, village. Edge, village. Para number four, you can see here, cell, concrete cell, so it is not there. Okay, bars, visitors, cell, cage, cell is given cage, but it was doesn't suit. Bars, visitors. Para number five, okay, night, eyes, cars, stars, nights, eyes. Stars, stars. This is the rhyming scheme of the poem which gives the similar sound. A, B, C, B, 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 all the five paras. That's all of today's poem. We'll conclude here. We'll see the next class. Bye then. Till then, see you. Bye-bye.